Hello and welcome to Powtech Virtual Talks on drying of thermally sensitive materials, spray drying and technical alternatives. And now we are going to listen to Hosokawa Micron, to Mr. Ashwin Jagmohan. And the topic is flash drying with preservative of heat sensitive components. Enjoy and empower yourself.
And welcome everybody. Thanks for joining the Powtech Virtual Talks. Volume 4. My name is Ashwin Jagmohan. I'm an application engineer and dryer specialist for Team Food at Hosokawa Micron Holland. I am a Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering and Process Engineering. And I will try to explain within 20 minutes our flash mill drying system. This I will do with a short movie from YouTube and 18 slides of a PowerPoint presentation. There we go. Well, Hosokawa Group is a worldwide corporation listed on the Japanese stock exchange. Hosokawa has 5 production locations with test centers and R&D departures in 5 different countries over the world. The corporation has an annual turnover of approximately €500 million with 1,600 employees. Well, this is where you can find me. This is an important production facility with a big test center located in Doetinchem, Holland, nearby the German border. In Doetinchem, we built the world famous, the world famous Hosokawa Nauta mixer. Also the Hosokawa vacuum batch dryers. We also built in Doetinchem the continuous flash mill dryers, the Drymeister, and the Flexomix agglomeration systems. The complete team at Hosokawa Micron Doetinchem, Holland, exists of 160 people nowadays. Now we go to the movie. Let's see if it's worked. Okay. Well, there is no sound, but I will speak through the movie. Our Drymeister DMRH flash drying system. Well, here we see what we call the basic open loop setup, a system with several components, machines working together, starting with a heater, a mixer feeder, the Drymeister dryer, a filter discharge through a rotary valve, a suction fan, and with a silencer. Now you see an automated movie. Well, here we see raw material coming from a conical mixer, transported by, for example, a full blade twin screw feeder. Material is entering the dryer chamber, falls onto a rotating milling disc, gets smashed into small particles, what you can see here. And when the particles are smashed in smaller pieces, you will have a quick and big surface enlargement. This will help also evaporating moisture. When the particles are not small enough and not dry enough, it gets smashed by the classifier wheel, gets a second chance, and when it's dry enough and light enough, it's quick enough to pass through the classifier wheel blades. Then it goes with the airflow towards a pulse air filter. The particles can't pass the filter bags, falls down to a rotary valve for controlled discharge in, for example, a bin, but it can also be a complete setup filling machine. And the air is separated from the particles, goes through a suction fan to the exhaust pipe. That is the situation for an open loop setup. So this was a movie. I hope it was clear. Then we go again to the slides. Okay. Well, here we see some typical heat sensitive products for feed and food applications. I made three categories out of it: valuable products, animal products, and food industry waste streams. Maybe better to call it side streams. Well, interesting upcoming business now is the alternative proteins derived from insects. We see more and more inquiries, especially for drying of larvae, but also some exotic vegetables, just to get interesting, valuable proteins out of it. And I think it's amazing to see the high conversion rates of, for example, the black soldier fly larvae. And for me, it's inspiring how we can reduce our footprint substantially just by consuming these alternative proteins a few days in a week instead of our normal meat products. And I think it's obvious that the world is in a kind of transition period. There is a change in the global mindset, and I think a serious awareness of air pollution, water pollution, sustainability, energy consumption, and so on. And as an indicator to me, for me, it's obvious we are in a kind of transition period. I think that's very positive. And I see more and more inquiries from companies worldwide asking us for a trial, or asking us to help them to dry several types of insects, several types of new plant material, vegetable material, just to get alternative proteins. Well, here I have listed the most important quality parameters our customers require for. The end product has to be a powder with a particle size of average 100 micron. The end moisture must be below 5%. That's what I see often. Customers are asking for fresh looking, nice smelling, light colored end product, a powder with high digestibility rates. Also what is asked often, and customers are happy with as much as possible intact proteins. And an indicator for intact proteins is the digestibility rate. Well, here I go to I go into the subject of drying. We can discuss this on a high academic level with enthalpy, entropy, van der Waals forces, and so on. But at the end, it's all about separating liquids from solids. And well, that can be done basically with two methods. You can do it by mechanical drying and by thermal drying. With mechanical drying, you can remove free water easily just by filtering or decantering. And with thermal drying, we can remove a lot of energy. We can remove water, but this requires a lot of heat energy. So you want to decrease as much as possible thermal drying, because typically it needs approximately 1 kilowatt hour to evaporate 1 kg of water. So it's wise to dewater first mechanically and then start further drying thermically. And with this sheet, I want to explain the importance for mechanical dewatering prior to thermal drying. And in this graphic below, the red line shows the amount of water to evaporate in relation to the dry matter. For example, if we have 1000 kg of wet input material with 90% of moisture content, which is the same as 10% dry matter, we have to evaporate 900 kg of water to achieve 100 kg of material. By means of a simple decanter, we can dry mechanically and remove free water easily, up to, for example, 60% of moisture, which is the same as 40% of dry matter. So then the situation will be that we only have to evaporate 600 kg of water to achieve 400 kg of dry material. So for 100 kg of dry material, you have to evaporate 150 kg of water. And that is 6 times less. And also 6 times less heat energy required for evaporation. And if you do the mechanical dewatering with a 3-phase decanter, I've put a small picture here, then you will have three streams coming out of the decanter: a water phase, an oil phase, and a wet pulp. The wet pulp will be the input material for our flash dryer. Well, here a sheet of some types of thermal dryers. Basically, you can divide thermal dryers in two categories: contact dryers or conductive dryers, and convective dryers. Well, the conductive dryer dries by means of heating up with a hot surface, and the convective dryer is drying by means of a hot airflow to heat up the material and to evaporate the solvents. And now I have a picture of the core unit of our drying system, our flash drying system. Well, we call this the Drymeister Micron dryer. And here you see that the hot air enters the dryer chamber from below the mill disc. The wet feed material enters the drying chamber from beside the wall. It falls down to the mill disc, goes with the airflow, then it dries quickly because of a huge surface enlargement, thanks to milling. And when it is dry enough and small enough, the velocity is fast enough to pass through the rotating classifier wheel, and then it goes further to the filter. Here I have put the four most important types of milling discs. We have in total 7 types. Here I just showed the 4 most important. We call it the new blade, One is called a multi-blade. We have a bar disc and we have a knife disc. We also have the low multi-blade and also a kind of smooth blade and a hammer blade. Well, the new blade is more for dispersion and less for milling. The multi-blade is more for slurries and very wet input material, almost to liquids. The bar disc is for milling effect, maximum milling effect. And the knife disc is more for fibrous material. Well, here you see a picture of the DryMeister dryer unit. This is a type 4. We have DMR types starting from the DMR1 up to DMR7. And in our test center, we have installed the DMR1 industrial system, which is also our pilot system. And we do all our tests on this DMR1 system, which is very well capable for giving us correct scaling up data with process guarantees and all needed. Well, here are some key features of the dryer. This dryer has a low and equal temperature impact on the material. Thanks to the milling effect, all particles are smashed into almost equal sized small particles and with the hot air entering the particle equally, you will have a kind of quick evaporation, homogeneous warming up and homogeneous evaporation. That's what we call the flash effect, which also cools down the material. And a typical residence time is 1 up to 3 seconds. You may call this ultra short. Well, we have response from our customers, for example, drying of coagulated chicken blood. We got the results from their laboratory, and the best runs had digestibility rates up to 97.2%. So we may say we can achieve digestibility rates up to 95%. Very much depending on material consistency, application, and also capacities. Well, the DryMeister is also very easy to clean. It has a compact dryer chamber with a non-complex rotor milling disc. And we also have complete SIP concepts for the wet part of the system. So for the feeding part, the Nauta conical mixer feeder, and also for this dryer, we have SIP concepts. With this system, you have drying, milling, and classifying in one operation. You have particle size control, adjustable, from 50 microns up to 1 micron. We have operating temperatures up to 300 degrees for food applications. And for drying of chemicals, it can go up to 650 degrees Celsius. And, well, this machine, we may say it's the most flexible flex dryer you can get. Well, to be honest, it's not always a hooray story. There are also serious disadvantages. For example, we have limitations for sticky and fatty products. If the material has an oil content higher than approx 11% in the dry matter, then we see some challenges in accumulation in the drying chamber, a kind of layer forming, which gives accumulation and, in the worst case, even blockage of the drying process. And that's not what you want to have in a continuous machine. So this is also why we use a three-canter prior to our dryer. Not always needed, but we have this advice, and we have close partners for a good matching equipment for our system. A second disadvantage is more in general for all flash dryers that you have large process gas volumes. So you have to take into consideration what to do about these large gas volumes regarding to what do you want to exhaust. And also a thermal energy consumption, well, typically 1.2 kilowatt hours per kg water evaporation without economizer. And if we may place an economizer additional to our system, then you can save heat energy up to 32%. And then it will be approximately 1.0 kilowatt hour per kg water evaporation. But also very, very much depending on material consistency and application and capacity. Well, here I have an realistic example of drying seafood residue to a nutritious fish oil and fish meal. Well, seafood residue is a mixture of head and backbones, fish guts, fish skin. Well, it first has to go through a cooker just to get rid of bacteria, and it also helps the fish oil and fat to separate easier. Well, after the cooker, the material goes to a three-phase decanter. This equipment will give an oil phase, a water phase, and a wet pulp. Well, the oil phase has to be purified, which can be done with a polisher. Then you achieve oil. The water phase can be concentrated with an evaporator, then it can be mixed with the wet cake, also coming from the decanter. And the mixture of the wet cake and the evaporated stick water can be mixed up to a ratio of 50-50. And this will be the feed material for our flash dryer. And then we will get a nice and nutritious fish meal. And this picture here, this is also the open loop configuration. Here is it once again, the open loop configuration. For most application, this is sufficient. And with a DMAR 5 system, it's already a large system. Not the biggest, but it is a large system. We can process almost 3000 kg per hour. We can dry from 50% to 5% moisture. And this by using 220 degrees hot inlet air. And we are able to not to exceed the maximum critical temperature of 65 degrees for this product. So here we have an empirical example of drying of heat sensitive material into a powder.
You have 5 more minutes.
Okay, thank you. That's enough. Well, we have several configurations, several setups. This is the open loop configuration. This is the basic configuration. Well, there are 3 main important subjects we have to take into consideration. The first is, what about dust explosion risks in the dry zone of the system? The second is, what about exhausted air want? And the third is, what about exhaust air odor or smell? Well, we have solutions for all these topics. Well, let's start with dust explosion risks. Well, you can choose for a closed loop configuration. This is an example of a closed loop configuration. With this setup, you can take out the vapor just by a condensator. You can use the hot air to preheat the fresh inlet air, and you can reduce the risk of dust explosion by recirculating nitrogen, but this is not always needed. Normally, a simple explosion suppression system is sufficient, but you can also choose for pressure shock resistance up to 10 bar, and that can be done for the filter, but also for other components. The filter is the most critical part of the system regarding to dust explosion risks. Here we have zone 20, most critical zone. Well, it's obvious because the situation inside is that you have hot air, you have fine particles of organic material. So I think it's quite obvious that we have here zone 20. But don't worry, we have proven technology. We have solutions for this, also sold systems, complete with all certifications required. Then we also have an open loop setup with a cyclone and a scrubber. Well, a cyclone can be placed if you have several materials to process. If you have a complete portfolio of several materials which you want to dry with our system, then a cyclone can be very smart to place instead of a filter. And then you have quick cleaning and quick product change. Regarding to the exhaust air, well, there are several solutions. Mostly we see the Venturi scrubber or a biofilter. Well, this is also depending on application and a local legislation, but also the capacities we are dealing with. And you can also place our Hosokawa Nauta mixture above the feeder. We have several types of feeding systems, also depending on the consistency, capacities, and so on. So we can advise you with which type of feeding configuration is required, which type of product and air separation is required, which type of system, and also which type of air treatment equipment. The last slide, a quick summary. I hope it is clear to you that Hosokawa has an interesting flash mill drying system with low heat impact by low product temperature, low heat impact by short residence time, homogeneous product quality with equal heat transfer, gentle to proteins, color, smell, and taste components, adjustable end moisture, complete ATEX safe system, and food standard equipment with SIP concepts for feeder and dryer. Well, I think it is just in time. If you have more questions, no problem to call me, to contact me, mail me directly, and then we can have more discussion in detail. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope we can do some business together, or that we can help you with your project. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Very nice presentation. Thank you for all the details. Now we have a bit of time for a few questions. I would like to ask Ms. Dr. Lee also to join. And if anyone has a question, you can write into the chat and we can also activate you. So if your microphone is working, then usually you could also ask your question. So just write in and...
Yeah,
I'm not really.
I see. Let me start with Mr. Cockle.
I will open the chat on the left-hand side, so it's perhaps easier for everyone to follow.
Oh yes, yeah, I have. Um, Is a spray drying.
Tobias Kocko, why is the milling and classifying unit not rated at ATAC zone 22?
Yeah, good question. Inside the dryer chamber, we below the nearby the milling disc, the material is still wet, and there is also a lot of moisture. So the situation there is not that critical compared with the situation in the filter. And well, we do also our hazard studies together with some notified bodies. And inside the drying chamber, the ATAC zone is 21, not 22. So that is a little more critical than 22, but also not required to set it on zone 20.
Okay.
Is it clear?
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay. Another question from Giro Vukmirovic. It's not to me, it's to Ashwin. He asked regarding regarding the minimum dry matter content of feed coming into the device.
So sorry, can you please?
Yes, minimum dry matter content of feed coming into the device.
Yeah. Well, good question. We have tested several slurries, very wet material, starting from 12%. Customer was asking us, do you have an alternative to the flash, to the spray drying system? To be honest, it is difficult to dry material below approx 20%, 20%, 50% of dry matter. Not only because you have to evaporate a lot of water to achieve a small amount of end product, but what we see also is we have to run the machine on the max, and that is not always what you want. If we sell machines, we also want to believe in it, and we want that the system works for decades. That is what Hosokawa stands for. And if we see it's quite challenging to achieve just a normal capacity, then the advice is better choose another type of dryer. So I think it will be reasonable to say if the dry matter content is below 20%, we see less chance to offer something reasonable. Often we see in drying of slurries a kind of stickiness, which also gives challenges in how to remove small layering inside the dryer chamber. Yes, we have options like a Teflon ring, several liners to place into the dryer. But you also want to keep the system as simple as possible and don't add strange options needed for a better process. So as an answer to your question, I think, let's say 20% of dry matter.
Perfect. I would like to, perhaps Dr. Lee is also having something to add because she has seen all the questions about her presentation. I would like to give you the chance to, yes, have a few words.
Yeah. So because I can have a chance of only a few words, so I can't say so much. But one, someone asked me about the high yield capacity that we have. So currently we are working on a design of the 1 ton per hour machine. So it is still on a design. So it is not already available, but hopefully in probably 2022, we would have it. Of course, you can also come back to us for further information about it. So some ask me about the inhalation, and with the small size particle, recently we work on some lactose project for inhalation. And the D50, the particle size D50 that we get is between 2 to 4 micrometers. So of course we will have to see, like, it depends on the solid content that we apply to, but it's something like also promising. About the whey protein or the stickiness or adhesions, and also at the milk products, what we can say is that we have the very low fat content on the surface because of it, so we don't have so much the stickiness on the surface. And also due to the very, let's say, like low water activity, we have the very good shelf life of the products, and we expect that after a few years, after a few months, we still can keep the very good flowability. You may check the YouTube links that probably later you will get my presentation through Powtech, right? Yeah, then you can check the link, and then you will see some of our demonstration about the flowability. So talking about the crystallinity, what we did is that with milk products, we already checked the XPS, and then we didn't see the influence to the crystallization of the products. And we hope that, I don't know, it is just at least for milk or dairy products. But then also, usually crystallization is formed by cavitation or some other, let's say like some crystallization seed. And in our case, we didn't notice it so far. We also can, another question regarded to the porous particles. I don't know how porous it can be. But we also try to work before with some, like, for example, silicon dioxide, silica, for example. And yeah, the results is also very positive. Of course, it depends a lot on different applications. I don't know if I still have some time or no.
Is, you know, yeah, everything is a little short-timed, and people are leaving already. So I would like to give Mr. Jagmohan also the chance to answer the last question inside of the chat. There is Yongwan Chin asking, can I dry the D-algomerate by filter cake? You have read the question.
I just gave him a reply in private, but I can just say it now. Well, you are asking for 3 micron. That is too fine. We can't go up to that fineness. Normally, we can give guarantee up to 50 micron. So if we want to have that fine particle size, then I think we have to deliver also a kind of grinding machine separately, which we also have. Hosokawa Alpine, our German colleagues, have various types of grinding and milling equipment. Yeah, they are the specialists in that. So I hope this is enough answer for you, Mr. Shin.
And Ms. Hozhavova has a question to Dr. Lee. I would really like to end this here. I'm very sorry that we are really running a bit out of time. We will have the time in mind next time, a bit earlier perhaps, and we will give you the opportunity to please contact the speakers, please communicate to each other. This is what we want with this virtual talks. We will be here again in February with explosion protection as a topic. And of course, if you have anything to add, if you are interested in anything working out with us, please contact us. We know that Powtech is a bit far from here, but we will stay in contact with you. Thank you for joining. Thanks also to the APV. She was they were working with us together on this presentation. Thank you to all the speakers. Thank you to everyone joining and staying with us all the time. I think we had plenty of people here, plenty of good topics. We wish you a great Christmas. And we are happy to meet you next year and hopefully soon in person.
Yes, a wonderful Christmas time to all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ole Reutner, for the great presentation and moderation. I couldn't do it without you.
Thank you. Bye, Miriam.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Yeah. Thank you all.
Have a great time. If you have questions, just send us an email to pautek@nurnbergmesse.de. And all videos will be available on our YouTube channel and on our website, but you can always ask for it. Talk about it to your colleagues, spread it to the world of Pautek. We would be glad to have you again next time. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, bye-bye.
Thank you, Mr. Jagmohan. Great presentation, thank you so much.
Thank you, Miriam. You also, Mr. Reutner and Ms. Hempel, thanks for helping us and, interviewing.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.